Chapter 5, SCR Systems. In this segment, we will focus on another component of after-treatment called Selective Catalytic Reduction, or SCR. SCR is a process that reduces the NOx that the engine or any combustion process puts out into the atmosphere. NOx forms in the exhaust gas when the temperatures in the combustion chamber are high, causing the nitrogen in the air to oxidize. NOx forms as a normal part of the process between diesel and gasoline combustion. The X on the NOx indicates there are several compounds of nitrogen and oxygen that are considered NOx and can be harmful to the atmosphere. NOx can combine in the presence of sunlight and hydrocarbons to form smog. Smog causes respiratory issues in some people, causing the EPA to put it on the list of pollutants that manufacturers must control. The emissions regulations changed for engines built starting in 2010, forcing an 80%+ reduction in allowable engine NOx output compared to previous engines. To achieve this standard, engine manufacturers had to add an after-treatment component to the exhaust system to treat the exhaust gas after it came out of the engine and before it releases into the atmosphere. What this meant was that another can or muffler-sized device was added to the exhaust system. What is SCR? SCR is a process that uses a reductant, also called a reducing agent, to reduce the NOx molecules to nitrogen before they release into the atmosphere. The reducing agent used is called diesel exhaust fluid, or DEF. A generic name for it is urea. DEF is a carefully blended aqueous urea solution of 32.5% high purity urea and 67.5% deionized water optimized for use on trucks. When DEF is injected into the exhaust stream, it decomposes to form ammonia. The ammonia goes downstream and deposits on the SCR catalyst element. As the exhaust gas passes through the catalyst, it reacts with the ammonia to form nitrogen, water, and CO2. Used in the electrical power plant industry for many years, SCR has never been adapted to mobile equipment like trucks until the mid-2000 timeframe. To adapt this technology to trucks meant much more than just adding a catalyst to the exhaust pipe. In fact, to keep ammonia from escaping from the exhaust system, an ammonia oxidation catalyst was added. Ammonia gas is an irritant and can be dangerous in higher concentrations. A tank to carry DEF on the vehicle was added, also lines and a pump to get the DEF to the dosing injection point. DEF freezes at about 12 degrees Fahrenheit, or negative 11 degrees centigrade. So equipment was added to take care of the system if it freezes. DEF expands a little over 10% when it freezes, just like water, so pumps, lines, and tanks need to be able to withstand freezing and thaw the DEF once the truck is in operation again. Drivers need to fill up the DEF tanks periodically to assure that the system is working. For vehicles manufactured from 2010 and later, there is quite a bit of new and additional equipment on the truck. Aside from the additional tank on the truck, there are coolant lines running to and from the tank to thaw out the DEF if it freezes. Also, the DEF lines and pump are electrically heated to allow that system to go to work soon after a cold start, if and when DEF components are frozen. Most DEF injectors have coolant lines running to them to cool the injector, since it mounts on the exhaust system as well. Overall, this makes for a complicated system to diagnose when something goes wrong. To both manage and diagnose the systems, a good number of sensors were added, including temperatures, DEF level, pressure sensors, exhaust gas composition sensors, and a coolant flow control valve. Engine manufacturers have gone to great lengths to make the systems easy to work on and fix. In our next video, we'll cover the turbocharger technology and how it has an integral role in emissions control and fuel economy.